The ad hoc committee, which was appointed by Parliament to investigate Nakawa Nagru land controversial giveaway, today interfaced with the Minister of State for Lands, Sam Mayanja. He told the committee that it was illegal for the Minister of Lands to direct the Uganda Land Commission to parcel out public land to private individuals because they do not empower ministers to direct ULC on management affairs.
The minister alluded to directive that when he entered the office, he found directives from the ministers to ULC. Just telling this committee, is that, do you consider that legal or illegal? You've been in lands for long.
Allocate so much from the land fund. I believe all these should have been independently arrived at by the commission. There should not be such directive for the ministry. From where I stand and from the law, maybe I'm being very legalistic, but from where I stand, such directives should be there. I should be there to guide the commission to evolve a criteria.
Mayanja wondered how Uganda Land Commission officials went on to comply with the minister's directive to give away Nakawa Nagru land, yet the constitution gives them independence to manage affairs of public land affairs. Mayanja, who is a lawyer by profession, says the ULC only reports to the president, not ministers.
The minister can only come in on the policy of government land. So the intervention of the ministry on policy would come in on policy, housing policy, land policy of the government. So I clearly saw that there was no way as a minister where I can come in to influence what is happening at the Uganda Land Commission. I was surprised when I read further the constitution and realized that the district land boards, there it is clear.
He also challenged the recent interdiction of the Uganda Land Commission Executive Secretary, Barbara Imario, saying the minister has no powers to interdict an officer appointed by the president.
You can't interdict whom you don't supervise. So she's appointed by His Excellency the President on advice of the Public Land Commission.
But committee members took on Minister Mayanja and accused him of being ignorant of the law that makes the Minister of Lands a supervisor of the Uganda Land Commission, only to run away from the responsibility of the maize in the public land management.
You are being in a serial academic, and I think you are going to cause problems for the president and that ministry. You are not going to have a law which is going to specifically state that you are the political supervisor. It is not going to happen. And the years I have spent here, I know of no law that specifically says a sector minister is a political supervisor. You are being academic. And if you are waiting for that law, it will not come.
I mean, I've seen you giving out matters of land. So are you saying that when it comes to, when you are giving those directives, you try to avoid the intersection on matters concerning the Land Commission?
However, Mayanja expressed the need for a law to streamline operations of the Uganda Land Commission to address all gaps in the land management.
I request that this comes out in your recommendation. We need an enabling law which will give a bit more detail on the work of the commission. There are so many things, as you indicated. The land bank, it has to be there. It is one of the things.
For me, I really think you are doing a very big disservice to the ministry. Take charge, provide what we call political supervision. By the way, neither in the constitution nor the enabling acts clearly provide for the duties of you, the ministers, the 83. You are not going to find anywhere that the state in the law.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.